other day, I can't remember what day it was. It might have been yesterday, I think. When I talked about how I feel emotionally abused and all of my symptoms are a result of me feeling emotionally abused. And I wasn't sure I'd have the guts to talk to my husband about it. I was feeling really passionate and honest in the moment. And it was bugging me enough for him to notice something was bugging me last night. So I told him what I was feeling in very careful words. I didn't say the word emotional abuse. I tried not to put blame. I used words like our dynamic, when you speak to me, when you get angry, this is how I feel, your level of intensity makes me question myself, makes me feel very on guard, and just tried explaining everything to him last night. And it was probably one of the first times I was able to have a really level-headed conversation about this topic when I wasn't in the middle of a crisis, when I wasn't in the middle of an emotional meltdown panic mode. And I could feel myself getting there because I didn't feel validated. I didn't feel he was supporting what I was saying. I felt shut down. I didn't feel listened. I didn't feel like he was really understanding what I was saying or even wanting to understand. I felt like he kept coming at me with his own angle, and we were definitely on two different pages when we were talking last night. The conversation ended with us basically agreeing that we weren't going to be able to fix anything in one evening. We could talk about it longer, but we chose not to. We decided to get going on dinner for the evening. We've been talking for over an hour. And the rest of the night was somewhat fine. I mean, there was a lot of little moments that I didn't feel like putting up with his crap, so I challenged him a couple times in a friendly, happy sort of manner. And I went to bed just whatever, you know, there's no solution. The positive thing that I did find in our whole hour-long conversation was that he was willing to listen to what I had said, to let it soak in, let him ruminate on it. He never agreed to agree with me, but he at least said he would think about what I was saying. And I really appreciated that about him, because that's not something he's usually said before about my words. So maybe we'll have more conversations like that in the future, where they're productive and they're healthy, they're not toxic or emotional. But then today, as you are about to watch, I'll edit this. I started to hit record while I was talking to my kids in the car. They were talking about their dad and how they felt about him and what they didn't like or what they thought was his, you know, not so good qualities. Every time I say he's mad at me, he gets mad.
Yeah, like, why are you mad at me? Then he gets mad.
Yeah, I should stop saying that.
Do you want to get him mad?
No, I don't.
Stop doing that. I know him. I can feel why that get mad at that.
I can see why.
Get annoying.
I bet. Make a good point, Matthew. What were you saying, Brooklyn, about school?
Didn't your teacher talk to you in school that you shouldn't jump to conclusions?
Oh! That's That's a big word, Brooklyn.
Like psychology?
Biology.
Biology.
You guys are pretty smart kids, you know that?
Yeah.
I can do 200 times 8. It might take 5 years to do that.
I can do 10, oh, hold 10 right. times 10.
100. Yells?
Yeah, when he yells, you don't know if you're going to break them, so what's wrong?
It's scary now.
I don't like it when you guys yell. Next time you guys start yelling,
the only time it was in Dad's fault, it was the time not that long ago. It was the time when, I think when he left, you know? Dad came to my room. I think he was there.
Let me ask you something. When Dad starts yelling and being really scary to me or to you guys, do you guys want me to just stay quiet? And not.
What would you act like?
And not stand up
you
for
be
us?
Dad and I be you.
Why are you doing this? I don't know.
Even if you don't know the answer. What
if I said, stop treating us this way, or you don't need to yell, or that's not very nice, you know, do you want me to stand up for us?
You can say, don't need to yell.
And, yeah. Okay, but then what happens if it keeps yelling? I've told you 1,000 times, I'm not yelling, I'm just raising my voice because you obviously can't hear me the first time, right? And then
don't
I have
tell him.
No!
So loud. Say that.
So
don't
what?
Don't say that. I have a bad idea. I'm the only boy in here. And I'm.
What does that mean? That boys have better ideas?
Yeah.
No.
Nope.
That's not fair. So we never finished talking though. What do I do when Daddy starts yelling?
So when you do. So when you do, you, like, be nice. It might calm him down.
So just basically let him treat us rudely and don't stand up for ourselves.
You always have to be right. If you want him to be more right, guess if you want him to not be that much mad, be nicer. Like, be nice when he yells.
Be nice when he yells.
Hey,
come on. Mom, you be dead.
I always hit your underwear.
I told you 1,000 times, blah, 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 blah.
Oh, it's okay.
I'll just go
and do it. Sorry.
What
can I be, Mom? Are you okay now? I did it. I want to go do it.
Now I'm
done.
What if I disagree or I don't want to? Do I have to do things I disagree with or that I don't want to do just to keep him happy?
Like go to the boys' bathroom?
Just to keep him happy?
No. You don't have to be so happy. You just need to get happy enough to be okay, not too mad. Be like yelling. That's the part where you just.
Let me ask you to make sure I understand. Dad's anger is my fault?
No.
Is it my responsibility?
Maybe, because it might be your responsibility not to get him mad.
Can't he just learn how to have a regular conversation without getting mad?
Yeah.
Why do I have to do all the work to calm him down? Why can't he learn to calm himself down?
Like you said, he was kind of spoiled when he was good.
Is that why
he gets angry? A lot of people get mad because if they don't get what they want.
Yeah, that's not a good, healthy way to talk to people, right? If you don't have what you want, you can't just get mad. Please stop.
So what? And that's the cue. Be nice to him, then. When you be more nice to him, guess what? Then he'll be less mad because nothing he'll yell at you about.
But what if I
do the dishes for him?
Disagree with him? What if I have my own ideas? What if I have my own feelings and he's not listening because he's used to having his way all the time?
Kind of lucky when he never listens to me that much.
I really hope that you understand what you're saying is not the answer. It's only a band-aid to the bigger problem. It's not going to fix the broken bones. It's only going to help us for a little while. And that's what I feel like I've been doing for so many years, is just being nice and shutting up and not saying anything to get him more mad.
Well, you saying stuff that are getting you more mad. You might think it might don't get him mad, but actually might get him mad.
What
are you like saying to him? Say? Well, you can stick up for yourself then.
That's what I'm saying. I only stick up for myself when I feel like he's wrong and I need to stick up for myself. Do you know what I'm saying? When he yelled at you for playing piano the other night, did you know I stuck up for you? Yeah. Because I don't want you growing up thinking that you're not allowed to play the piano. Okay? And all Dad wants you to do is just play it softer. But do you know that? He didn't tell you that. He didn't communicate that very well.
Don't even communicate?
Yeah, he just yelled at you for playing the piano. He didn't say you were playing it too loud. He didn't say, please play it softer. He wasn't calm about it at all. He just yelled at you, and that's not okay. It's not okay to blow up at everything, right?
Right.
I don't want you to blow up at everything as a kid, as a teenager, as an adult. I'm trying to set an example for you. Same with you, Brooklyn. I don't want you blown up at everything, okay? So when Dad's blowing up at everything to you guys, to me, blowing things out of proportion, jumping to conclusions, making a big deal out of nothing. That's when I have to stand up and say, no, this is not okay. Okay? I can't keep pretending that it's not happening.
So don't listen to Dad that much then. Like don't listen, you know what I mean?
You just need to learn what's right and wrong and don't use your dad as an example.
Yeah, that one. Don't use him as an example. Use you.
I don't know if you should use me. I'm not that good either. Okay? If you don't like the way I'm being a mom to you, I'd like you to talk to me about it. Right? We can work on it. I can learn better. If you don't like the way I'm being a wife, we could talk about it.
What do you mean?
You know, you think I should be quiet and not make Dad mad. But there's some things I need to stand up for. Brooklyn, put it down. Don't you think? There's some things I need to stand up for.
If little thing that you accidentally took his, a favorite popsicle, because they never let, and he never shared that. You don't even know that Dad even shares.
Dad doesn't know how to share.
Except for sharing his money. When he helps you, when he paid $500 to keep you.
Okay, actually, I'm he bought it for himself for too, Dad right? Now, because he does know how to share.
He does? That's good. But yesterday, I stood up for myself when I know I put that pen on the fridge. I know I did. And he told me that I always lose pens and I'm always taking pens and taking them to the other room. And he's right. Okay? But I'm also right. I know I put that pen there. And that's what I needed to stand up to him.
I have to agree with you that because that happens to me a lot.
I stood up for myself. I said, no, you can't call me a liar when I know the truth. Do you know what I mean? And then he wouldn't apologize for the longest time.
He apologized to me.
Right. And then he finally apologized to me because he realized that he was being a jerk.
Is it the sweaty or what? Because my eyes are sweating now.
You ready to go in?
Yeah. All right. Think it better.
I did my best not to coach them to say anything. I tried not to give my own personal opinions. I really wanted them to say what they felt like they needed to say. And I also wanted to give them a perspective that kept them mutual. Because at some point, my son tells me that when dad's mad, mom, don't make him more mad by yelling back at him. Just be nice to him and tell him whatever you need to tell him so that he stops yelling. And in a 10-year-old's mind, that is the best solution ever, right? High school conflicts, girlfriend drama down the road. Keep the peace, mom. Mom, keep the peace. That's what he's telling me, right? He has that concept, and that's really smart of him. But how long do I have to do that for? How many years do I have to play the nice one and let Jim have his way? Let Jim be the yeller and calm him down when he's accusing me of things or he's telling me things that are not true for me and I need to clarify how I really feel or how it really is. You know, I need to be able to stand up for myself, and I needed my son to hear me tell him not all cases are going to work, you know, for your little solution there, son. I think it's a great idea, but I need you to understand that when daddy is telling me that I'm not being honest and I'm telling him that I am, or when daddy thinks it's that he's right and he's wrong, and it's really important that he doesn't yell at me, and it's really important that he doesn't treat me like I'm wrong, then I need to stand up for myself. And if he's treating my kids poorly, like if he's yelling at the kids for bad reasons, you know, for poor reasons, I don't know how I explained it to him, I need to stand up for my kids too, so he understands that daddy's not always right, and just because daddy yells doesn't mean that he's entitled to. And he also heard me tell him that daddy is allowed to stop yelling. We don't have to always do what dad wants us to do just because we're scared of him yelling. We don't need to keep putting band-aids on it. We really need to fix the broken bones. We really need to fix daddy from yelling all the time by daddy fixing himself. We don't need to keep placating. I didn't say that word, but that's really what we're doing, is we keep appeasing the spoiled child who won't stop throwing the tantrums by giving the tantrum-throwing child what he wants. We can't keep doing that. That's not going to help anything. That's just going to make him feel even more entitled. And I don't think a 10-year-old will understand that. And I know Brooklyn didn't really understand what I was saying, but I think they understood enough of it to know that there's not something right. So Matthew said something to the effect, that means I can't, I shouldn't look to daddy on how to act or something like that. He doesn't want to have dad be his example. And I said, for some things, you know, but not when it comes to, you know, how he reacts and gets mad at everything. And he says, I should look to you. And I was honest with him. I said, honey, I'm not perfect either. You need to learn for yourself what is right and what is wrong. And if you feel like somebody is not treating you right, if it's me, you know, talk to me about it. If it's somebody else, talk to them about it. And that's what I really wanted him to hear, is that nobody's perfect. We're all learning this as we go. So if he can really understand someday that his initial gut reactions might be to yell and scream and throw a fit or demand his way, that's not the right way of handling things. You know, that's really, we're not continuing the cycle, you know, that has been passed down. And you know, I'm in a frustrated spot right now where I'm already tired of fighting, and I don't want to continue thinking that I'm emotionally abused. I'd rather pretend that I'm not, because it's easier to deal with. I'm already tired of playing the emotional abuse card, which I can't say that it's fake, but I can't tell you that it's real, because I want to believe that it's not. Does that make any sense? So I'm kind of in this back and forth in between stage, which totally makes sense why I've had almost a year or 2 years with not talking about emotional abuse on my videos, because it's such a serious thing that I've been covering with this veil of denial that I really need to open my eyes and be aware of my surroundings and aware of his words and aware of my reactions and aware of my perception and aware of my expectations, and maybe I even put some emotional abuse back on him because of how attacked I feel all the time. I probably feel like that's my only recourse, is to play his game, is to fight dirty back with him. I don't know if any of this makes sense. I don't even know if I'm correct in my thinking, or maybe I'm missing something completely, but I'm telling it how it is, because this is how it is for me. I'm living it daily. It's not as bad as what some women have to go through. It really isn't. But it's bad enough for me to wake up and notice it, recognize it, address it. I still don't want to leave him, but yet a part of me does. I still don't want to get a divorce, but a part of me doesn't want to deal with this marriage anymore. I don't want to die. I want to be there for my kids, but I'm really tired of living this way. I'm really tired of living this way. Anyways, I will talk to you all later. Bye-bye.